Hi, I'm Alec Young. I am a first-year medical student at OSU Center for Health Sciences in Tulsa. I am reporting our study on the adherence to reporting guidelines and trial registration in infectious disease journals. And those are all of the authors that worked on this study. So kind of background, we all know that research studies are what guide healthcare practices and the decision makings. So that being said, we need to make sure that those research studies are reproducible and standardized. And oftentimes we have guidelines that allow those things to happen. And so those guidelines can either be recommended or required. And so the main objective of this study was to evaluate the instructions for editors, pages on the infectious disease, and look into the rates at which those guidelines were recommended and reported. So kind of the process of how we did this was we took the top 100 infectious disease journals, which was identified by the 2021 Scopus Site Score tool. And then once we solidified our list of 100, we then investigated the instructions for authors page, as well as contacting the editorial staff of those journals to ensure which studies they actually did accept with their journals. And then from all of that, we extracted data regarding the reporting guidelines and if they required, recommended, or did not mention, or did not accept. And then we did this in a masked triplicate fashion. And so these are kind of the results that, well, not kind of, but these are the results that we found, with figure one showing a more in-depth process of how we actually arrived at the 100 journals. So we originally had 293 journals as reported on the Scopus Site Score. We took those top 100, and then we did have to remove two, one being because it was a book series, which only had reviewing research, so we couldn't access it, as well as it wasn't a study that really accepted a lot of the guidelines that we were looking into. And the second one we had to remove because it was discontinued as of 2022. So that then gave us two off from the 100 that we needed. So we added in two, just 101 and 102 that were on the site score list. And then table one here shows a really simplified list of what we found. So the first three being the consort, which is for clinical trials, PRISMA, which is for systemic reviews, and ARRIVE, which is for in vivo experiments. And those were the top three reported guidelines that we found in infectious disease journals. The next two, MOOSE and QUORUM, MOOSE being for observational studies and QUORUM being for meta-analyses, those were the least reported guidelines that we found. Here's some more results. So figure two is showing that we also looked for the ICMJE reporting guideline, and we found that over 80% of journals did mention ICMJE in some form or fashion. Figure three showed that for studies that required clinical trials, almost 70% of those journals mentioned that statement, with the large majority of those that mentioned it being requiring clinical trials. So conclusions from the study were just that consort well and above, if we kind of look more into detail there, but consort absolutely above and beyond, almost 75% was reported in all of those infectious disease journals, with PRISMA and ARRIVE being the next two after that, most reported. We also found that not many of those reporting guidelines that we looked into were mentioned, with, as we said, MOOSE and QUORUM being those least mentioned, but overall we had consort, PRISMA, and ARRIVE being way mentioned a lot higher than a lot of the other guidelines. And so kind of the big takeaway here is that a future requirement of reporting guidelines by infectious disease journals may aid in increasing both the transparency and reproducibility of the research, as well as standardizing the data reporting. And here is our references, because we had a long list, and our acknowledgments. Thank you.